Hi everybody, I hope you're having a great day. In this video, I'm going to be covering Solomon Grundy, born on a Monday. Now, Grundy has had several different incarnations over the years, with varying backstories. But for the purpose of this video, I'm going to be covering the most current version. And although his very first appearance was in All-American Comics issue number 61 in October 1944, this current version made its debut in Earth 2 issue number 3 in September of 2012. Now, a fun fact is that Solomon Grundy's name actually comes from a poem that was published by Edwin Arlington Robinson, who won the first two Pulitzer Prizes for poetry. But the DC Comics character's real name is Cyrus Gold, and he stands 7 feet 5 inches tall, weighs 517 pounds, having black eyes and white hair. Now, Grundy has a unique zombie physiology, and because of this, he has vast energy absorption abilities, being able to absorb various forms of energy and manipulate them, although this is shown to be mostly subconscious, showing that Grundy is likely far more powerful than he has the intelligence to realize. He's near invulnerable, having vast durability against physical attack, and also being able to survive without food, water, or oxygen. He has vast regenerative abilities, especially while being at the Slaughter Swamp where he was created. And if he is destroyed, he's always resurrected at some point or another. Grundy also has superhuman stamina and strength, which tends to vary from incarnation to incarnation, at some points being able to be restrained by a group of normal people, but on other occasions being arguably stronger than Superman. He also has varying elemental plant qualities, being able to absorb life energies from beings using vine-like extensions, as well as occasionally being able to use something akin to a fatal touch. His only weakness, in my opinion, is that at the very best, he has a moderate intellect, most often being shown having below average intelligence. Now, after more than 100 years lying dead in this occult muck called Slaughter Swamp, Solomon Grundy returned as a huge, nearly invincible avatar of the Gray, being a life-draining elemental force that was against the life-giving Green. Being diametrically opposed to the Green Lantern, he's a walking force for decay. The Earth 2 man who would become Solomon Grundy was a butcher that was driven into a murderous rage when his wife committed suicide after she was attacked by his boss, named Henry Pittance. He took out Henry and a couple of his acquaintances before he ended up taking his own life at the edge of Slaughter Swamp, which was located behind the butcher shop. With his last breath, he recited a simple nursery rhyme that he used as a lullaby for his newborn child. His body then descended into the depths of the swamp. But the elemental essence of the swamp wouldn't let Grundy die, changing him into an undead avatar of the Gray, the decaying force that opposes life. This being of great elemental strength was awakened when the Green anointed Green Lantern Alan Scott, also known as Sentinel, as its champion. Grundy then set out to battle the Green, first setting upon Washington, D.C. to draw Scott's attention. Scott had aligned himself with a team called Wonders of the World, and therefore Hawkgirl, Flash, and the Atom were with him when they went to confront Grundy. Now, Grundy's plant elemental nature made him mostly immune to the power of the Green Lantern's ring, and his healing factor kept him in the fight even when Scott split his upper torso in half and Atom crushed his body to a pulp. After Grundy actually beat the rest of the Wonders, Alan Scott summoned the strength to fly him into space and stranded him on the moon, where he assumed he would stay because there were no living things for the power of the Gray to attack. But, as we all know, you can never really stop a zombie. Now, due to his powers and abilities and his influence on the DC Universe, for my 1 to 10 rating, I'll give Solomon Grundy a rating of 9, which is an epic rating. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. I'll talk to you next time. Be sure to like and subscribe to The New Sage.